Here comes Butler.
Under the mistletoe last Christmas, he said he wouldn't kiss her under an anesthetic. But she's an awful woman for giving him, so she was nagging the whole way down in the car, nag, 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 nag. She was still nagging and we taking her down off the roof rack. And then she wasn't in the hotel 2 minutes and she was nagging again. She was showing in the guest register and there was a little flame went across the top of the page. She said it's bad enough that there's space in the hotel, but when they come down to see what room you're staying in. She was saying, I can't stay, you know, there's no window, no tires, there's not even a door. We said, shut up, you're in the lift. my mummy doesn't really love me. These dudes are a hard build. Yeah, it's worse than that. She said she wasn't expecting me at all, she just picked up the there I was. And she said to the doctor, put that one back and give me to a smaller answer. I was very sick as a child. I spent 2 weeks in an incinerator. No, I'm sorry, you think about it. No wonder the ass was burnt off me. But you know the way that they talk about mummies? Do you know mummies are all about loving you and all? And nowadays they blame the television for all the violence in the world. It's all they say on computer games and on the televisions and all. It's all violence now. Well, we know who introduced me to violence and there was no television. It was me mummy. Who else would look at an innocent child and say, I'm going to kill you? Or who else would follow you up 3 flights of stairs with the leg of an armchair and let you into town? Where's that apple tart me last night? If it was a strawberry shortcake, you'd have a fractured skull. Well, my mummy was always asking me to do things that you couldn't possibly do. So, you couldn't do them anyway. But she was always asking me, like, shut your mouth and eat your dinner. And then she said, come over here to me, you, and don't move. And then the best one was, if you fall off that wall and break both your legs, don't come running to me. Or she'd catch you when you come down the stairs, look at the dust at the back of your ears. You're like, I can't do it. I tell you now, another good one. I was down in the old bar, so I was before I came home. And I was getting myself an old sneaky package of bags. So I was pulling out on the machine and I swung back a bit hard and I hit this woman on the bosom. And I said, I'm sorry, look, but if your heart is as soft as your bosom, you'll forgive me. And that's what she said to me. She said, is that if the rest is as hard as your elbow, here's my number. So he was walking through anyway, he jumped out and said, I'm the devil. He said, pleased to meet you, I married your sister. Okay, I was over down the other day. But in about 6 weeks, he went on the beer and he never came home. And after about 3 weeks, she decided that she'd better report him missing. So she went down to the Garda station and the Garda asked for a description. And she said, well, I suppose he's about 6'4". Big muscles, broad chest, lovely long, curly hair. I said, Mammy, that doesn't sound like my daddy. She said, you and the name of God wants him back. But they went out shopping the other day and he got asked that question that no man should ever get asked. She came out with the changing room and the dress and she turned around and she says, does my bum look big at this? And my father took a look at the tag and saw the price tag and he says, your arse is about as big as a barbecue grill. So we're in the bed anyway and that was getting a little bit frisky. You know how it is with the weather. So we tried to lean up again and he said, any chance? She said, not at all. He He said, how come? She said, there's no point in lighting the whole barbecue for one wee sausage.
Bitch out the window.